New York Governor Andrew Cuomo said the president's agenda is a promising blueprint for economic development with a focus that mirrors our approach in New York to bring jobs and businesses back from overseas and create new opportunities for the middle class to grow. WPTZ News Channel 5 is your political source on air and online.
Yeah, we have a politics tab on our website. Check it out at WPTZ.com. New tonight, the fireworks continue between the man called the face of Vermont Public Television and the board that oversees VPT. We were the first to bring you word of the investigation into VPT's board by the Corporation for Public Broadcasting. Tonight, new elements emerging as to what prompted that probe. WPTZ's David Charnes is live in the newsroom with more. David.
George, several people involved with VPT tell us that the board has a tense relationship with President and CEO John King. Tonight we're getting a glimpse into that tension.
Sources tell WPTZ that some of the nearly two dozen closed-door meetings held by Vermont Public Television's board over the past 2 years focused on the television station's president and CEO, John King. Those closed-door meetings triggered an investigation by the Corporation for Public Broadcasting. The board admits the investigation revolves around the panel's failure to summarize the closed-door sessions after the fact. The board has reported those sessions involved personnel matters. Multiple sources tell WPTZ the personnel matters discussed concern King. King, a 25-year veteran of public television, has been the CEO since 1998. He also sits on the board, though he was not included in many of the sessions. In 2012, an employee complaint was brought to the board against King. The CEO tells WPTZ it was investigated and was found to be unsubstantiated 3 months later. Some of the closed-door meeting sources say included a Burlington law firm and a local consulting agency hired to review the complaint against King. In a statement regarding the 2012 complaint, King wrote, "It is the obligation of the board to protect all personnel matters. I would be outraged if any personal information of staff or management was compromised. I'm not going to jump to any conclusions here, but there are serious consequences for a board that cannot protect personnel matters of its staff." King goes on to state, "The matter at hand is the board's compliance with open meeting requirements, not a closed and confidential personnel matter. Let's focus on improving VPT's compliance, not changing the subject." Some of the senior management at the television station admits the relationship between King and the board is strained, according to a letter sent to the panel last month. Four members of the management team wrote, "We understand that John has lost the confidence of several members of the board. We speak unanimously, however, when we say that he has not lost ours."
The board declined to make a comment today when we asked them about this story. Also, we have asked many of the parties involved in this matter for on-camera interviews. So far, they've all declined. Live in the newsroom tonight, I'm David Charnes, WPTZ News Channel 5.